are seeing, degradatory systems are seen. See, except the opportunity, somebody told, my father was not so knowledgeable, I am very knowledgeable. At your father's time, he was doing some agriculture or something and he is not exposed to that of the modern developments, number one. And number two, they were so in poverty, they were so in a developing state, so that they went to hard work and they were totally detached from learning or anything. They learned something and they started earning and taking care of the family. Because of the domestic commitment, number two, because of non-exposure to developed tools like computer, education, accessibility, affordability, etc., they would not have learned all of these things. If the same people with the same stigma, if the same type of stigmatic way of approaching knowledge and assimilating of knowledge, even the same qualities regarding the qualitative eligibility for getting knowledge, your parents were greater than yourself, really. Your father or great grandfather or even the great ancestors, they were having all qualities for good education. That is good retention power, good absorption power, good physical sturdity in health, and good common rational reasoning and thinking. You are having calculator, and for each and everything you refer a book or touch a machine. Without that, they were having innate skills of logical reasoning, calculus, they know about seasons, they know about the situations, they know about more thing in common experience, they know lot of things about common sense, and what about their laukika jnana? What is good and what is bad? This appears to be good, but it is really bad. It appears to be bad. So they can understand the pseudo dynamic exposure of realities as well as falsities, and they can call out the reality or the essence out of it. So your great grandparents, they were having more eligibility for knowledge retention, for knowledge boosting, everything, etc. And the flaw is only a language or a person's opportunity to learn or exposure to modern tools. If they are given the same thing, they would have done 10 times more than your achievement. If you are placed in their level, you would not have moved not even a percentage of their accomplishment or your present accomplishment. So now nobody is dead. Now we are seeing only degradation. Biodegradation, geodegradation, auto-degradation, everywhere we are seeing degradation. So you are having two problems. See, if somebody is in degradation, for example, if there is a patient, immediately the doctor will not come and he will not give him a tonic. First of all, a sick person should be made healthy. And a healthy person will be boosted for more health and sturdity. If a person is minus A, he cannot be directly brought to plus A. He should be brought to A. That's why we are telling about two things. One is upliftment, second is development. What is upliftment? Minus A brought to A is known as upliftment, and A brought to A plus or double A is known as development. So this is upliftment and that is development. Now, everybody is talking about upliftment of humanity and breeding. First of all, we must understand that we are below normal. We have to uplift the human tendency physically, physical fertility, mental fertility, intellectual fertility, then directive fertility of principles of progenics, how to get a good child. There are principles. We must be having a great awareness, without which we cannot proceed this science at all. So we must come back to normalcy. Now we are below normal. Then we have to think about producing normal people, abnormal people, and supernormal creatures. So there is a possibility for divine intervention, coming God as the child, I have already told. And even though a person's progenic fertility is more, the circumstantial intrusion, I have given the second example. Third thing, by a spiritual blessing is also possible. For example, Gandhari, she was blessed with Durvasa. And she got from that blessings, she was infertile and she got children. And you know that is through Durvasa, a rishi. And by parthenogenesis, or by celestial influence, or a divine intervention by means of an asexual, agendric influence, what we call agendric or asexual influence, by the parthenogenetic blessings of Surya and other Indra and other deities, Karna and other various issues have been brought by Kunti. So celestial influence is also possible. It is possible by celestial representations, delegations, or celestial authorities. If it is by Karna and other people who are brought by the gracious intervention of Surya, etc., that is celestial. That is celestial authority. Celestial delegation is through Vyasa, you know, that Amba Ambalika Vyasa story where Dhritarashtra and other people came. So it may be celestial authority or celestial delegation, it can be brought. So there is agenetic, antogenetic, antigenetic, seprogenetic, supragenetic, parthenogenetic, paragenetic, conogenetic, innumerable divine ways of getting children where possible. They have been shown lot of mythological, various other experiments have been given, various other elucidations have been made, and in Vichara, in Vedanta Shastras and Vicharas, the possibilities the probabilities, the ascertainments of those things phenomenally and scientifically possible, they have also been discussed and dealt with details. So we must understand that even with our shastras, getting a godly child is possible, getting God as child is possible, getting a great child is possible. So where we are seeing all of these things, we have to create a faith which will make us to enter into the shastric injunction. If there is a possibility in the shastras to get abnormal and supernormal interventions, why can't there be a natural expected child for a good social and domestic harmony and well-being? Why can't it be? So it is known as Kaimuthika Nyaya or Kimpuna Nyaya in our shastras. If we can get that much, why can't we get this much? It is very easy and possible. So now we are going to start this science with few exemplifications. I thought of just writing a lot of things in the board so that everybody can know, because it is a practical exercise. Narration, it especially that is very much speedy, and this type of fluency will show that I know things. And my purpose is not to show that I know, also to make you feel that you also know, and to also pass on to your generations and the available people. So it is very difficult, but still I will say something. It starts with panchabhyasa, avabodhana, bodhana, prabodhana, udbodhana. These are the exercises. If you note down, you can write a note down, that will be more useful. Okay. What is, first is avabodhana. What is avabodhana? Avabodhana is, you have to understand. If you want to create a good child, you must understand the qualities of good side. You have to understand five things. One is parimiti, second is arhata, third thing is sthiti, fourth thing is paristhiti, fifth thing is upaya. If you want a good child, then what is your eligibility to produce a good child? What is your eligibility to produce a good child? That is your arhata. If you are not having the eligibility to produce a good child, or even if blessed, for example, it is known as Gajakeli. What is Gajakeli? You can throw a big ball, you can throw a big wooden log towards an elephant. Just there is a throw ball game, na? Like that you can just throw something on an elephant. It will catch it if it is trying. If it throws on you, can you catch it? That is Gajakeli. So you must be qualified. Everybody is bothered about only getting the benefit. They are not bothered about their eligibility to get the benefits. Yes, I want a great son. Then what is your eligibility to bear such a person? Gajagarbha. How can you carry those things? How can you produce this? So I donate you two elephants. Two elephants is just 20 or 30,000. And if it is brought in the back door way, it won't cost anything at all. We can bring and donate two elephants to Dr. N.S. Ramaswamy as a token of my affection. But to take care of these things and to know about their sentiments, feelings, expectations and other instincts, and to take care of them, it is not only with the things of just financial resources to feed, but also understanding of the behavior, understanding of the responses and instinctive provocations of the elephant, that requires some extra knowledge, without which you cannot do that, apart from financial resources for feeding. So you must have that arhata, number one. Arhata, adhikara, which very frequently NSR used to say. So arhata we want. Second thing, parimiti. That is the limitation. In which area we are having that deficit. That is known as parimiti. Then the third thing, sthiti. What is our position? What is our environment? Fourth thing is paristhiti. What is the environment required for the child?